COVID-19, the pandemic in China, has been well under control. How to ward off outbreaks is still a top priority. China's top legislature is keen on laws to strengthen the legal safeguards for public health, according to a government work report. I talked to Margaret Chan on the sidelines of the two sessions, the former Director General of the World Health Organization. Now she's a member of the CPPCC Standing Committee. She's a straight talker. As a global public health advocate, she handled the aftermath of SARS and then bird flu and Ebola. With new virus variants and a shortfall in vaccines, she said international cooperation is the only way. Let's listen in. By the end of 2021, according to the COVAX goal, 20% of the member countries that are joining COVAX, their populations will be covered by COVAX. That's according to the plan. Still, 80% of the world population do not have access to vaccine. What does it mean for the end game?
Well, everybody is talking about the end game. Now, for someone who's been in this business in public health for so long, we need to be very humble when we are dealing with a new virus. And particularly COVID-19 virus, it is a very tricky and very cunning virus. And every turn, we see surprises. So I would advise leaders in the public health community to guard against complacency, to maintain vigilance, and follow the science and respect the science and take coordinated approach at the global level to confront and to tackle this common enemies who is invisible, truly.
When you look at what's going on, there is a very complicated geopolitics, Ms. Chan. You understand that when it is combined with a pandemic, because when you were Director General of the World Health Organization, then you were experiencing different versions, but similar circumstances. How do you see this is likely to be done? Is geopolitics going to be the determining factor whether we're going to be able to fight this pandemic this time?
The lessons that I have learned, having been in in the position of former Director General of the Big Show, there were no lack of warning in terms of our health system preparedness, being able to detect and also to respond at the onset. Now, this is something that in the post-pandemic era, countries at the country national health security as well as global health security, we must take heed this time. We cannot miss this opportunity again. Now, the second lesson we need to learn or to ask ourselves, Ebola, COVID-19, or as far as we go back to HIV/AIDS, these are what we call zoonosis. Why are we seeing zoonosis? Well, Tian Wei, as a fact, I was advised by scientists in the last 20 to 30 years, about 70% of the disease we are experiencing as human beings jump from the animal sector. So when they were able to cross this interface, the animal-human interface, it will bring harm to people. We as human beings, we need to review our consumption pattern. We need to review our respect for ecosystem balance and for the nature, as well as diversity. We haven't done that well enough.
As we know, even as head of World Health Organization, as you were earlier, you could not function without the support of member countries of the United Nations.
If countries come together and have a dialogue, yes, they may disagree at some point, but whether or not they can find consensus on the way forward, because our vulnerability is universal. It doesn't matter which country you are from, because we have no immunity to this new disease. So the only way out of this crisis is global cooperation through multilateralism, use the platform of the United Nations. Now, I recall when I was the Director General of the World Health Organization, I worked extremely closely with the then Secretary General, Mr. Ban Ki-moon. Now, there were no lack of crises of different nature, but we managed to convince governments, at least as their civil servants, international civil servants, we managed to convince governments in the interest of people, in the interest of social and economic development, to come together to achieve consensus on the way forward to tackle our common enemy.
I remember earlier at a virtual meeting, Tom Frieden, the former CDC director of the US, was saying, it is now or never. He was talking about the cooperation that should happen between China and the US. What would you say?
Now or never, this is the opportunity. Why the COVID-19 pandemic is perhaps the most severe in terms of severity, in terms of speed, in terms of moving to affect so many countries and touching every human individual, either directly or indirectly. So this is an opportunity for global cooperation to solve this enemy.
Another issue, China is getting older before it gets rich. Now, if you look at the year 2025, you will see 300 million surpassing the age of 60 years old. What does that mean for this country, which you pay a lot of attention to, in terms of health structure, in terms of welfare, in terms of the public health preparedness? What does that mean?
Well, this is a very big question. Well, from my perspective, aging of the population is happening in many countries. When you look at aging of the population, the good thing is, because of medical development, medical advancement, people live much longer and better nutrition and so on and so forth. There are many reasons why people live so long. Now, on the downside of it, there comes many social problems, family problems, and also the family, the government, and the community need to address this together. So my advice is that China still have an opportunity, still have a window of opportunity to develop an affordable, sustainable social protection system. But it would require the whole of government and the whole of society, every individual must take part in this big adventure.